Hello, Twin Flames. Thank you for being here, for liking, subscribing, and all the amazing comments and feedback you leave me. It means the world, as you know. Look at this little beauty. I've had this for Christmas off one of our subscribers, and I thought I'd use this today to prop the cards up. And I really do appreciate all the comments, you know, saying get stands for the cards and all these things. But I really like using quirky little things to stand the cards up, you know. I'm going to be on the hunt for an angel. I just think it's a bit more interesting than having a normal card holder, you know, or just holding the card. So I just thought it was a really cool idea. So it's Sunday today, guys, and tomorrow we start the new series. I'm so excited. It's going to be a series about how to find your way to union. And I'm going to give you cards. I'm going to talk about the angels, give you clear ways of how you can improve and enhance your journey so that union comes quicker, it's more fun, you have a better time, you work on you, and it's going to be really good for self-love. So I'm super excited for that. But today, let's do some cards. So what cards, angels, shall I use today? I'm just seeing what's around. I'm going to use the Grand Lux Tarot. So what do we need to know, please, for the feminines today? What guidance have we got for the feminines today, please, angel? Going to take them until they stop jumping out. There we go. What do we need to know for the divine masculines today? Wow, look at that one. And what do we need to know? These are flying out, so I'm taking the ones I'm guided to. What do we need to know about the journey? Thank you. And then I'm going to use some healing cards as well. Oh, the deck's falling on the floor. So the cards that are falling on the floor, I'm just going to put them to one side because everything happens for a reason. So what do we need to know for the feminines today, please, angels? What do we need to know for the feminines? For the masculines, what do we need to know? What do we need to know? And what do we need to know for the journey today? Thank you, thank you, thank you. So first of all then, let's start with the journey. So the journey today, wow, it's about courage. Courage, and the masculines are finding their courage right now. Their courage to leave behind their karmic situations, to find their feminine, to find you. They've got the light on there, so they're seeking answers. You know, they're going within. And we've got this person here trying to grab onto the masculine. And this will be the karmic person or the karmic situation. Whatever's keeping them away from you right now, whatever's distracting them. Because remember, nothing can keep them away from you. But things distract them along their path. So this is something that's grabbing onto them. And it doesn't necessarily have to be a person. It can be something that they are dependent on. A situation, a career or a job. Something that they are addicted to. You know, that they are using as a crutch in the 3D because they're afraid of facing their truth. So they are walking away now from this. And they are starting to seek answers. And feminines, if you're still holding on to your masculine, you know, if you're still wanting to control things, if you're still focusing on the how, the when, the why, still thinking about the way they've treated and hurt you, you have to let go. So this is also a sign for feminines to surrender, to let it go. And you're going to learn all about how to do this in this new series. So, you know, get back up on your feet today. If you're feeling a bit down, if you're feeling a bit lost, if you feel like it's a struggle, Archangel Michael is with you saying to you, get up, soldier, get up, warrior, I have got you. And it's showing you that right now it's a time to focus on gaining stability, sorting out your money, sorting out your financial situation, working on work. You know, things that are bringing the dollar in, you know, things that are going in and on the 3D to bring in what you need to bring in. This is what the masculines are focusing on right now because it's important. So it's about priorities. You know, working on your day-to-day to build a better future. And you want to build a better future together. And this is what it's showing me here, you know, the forward motion. They show me the ship in the background, like the future progress being made. So get things in order today. You know, start thinking about what you want to do. But trust and have faith that the masculines are finding their courage right now. And that you need to find courage to let go and surrender. So the masculines pay attention to signs. So they are receiving signs and synchronicities. And someone asked me what the number 10 meant. It's power. It means power coming in. It's very much connected with when the seal of stability came off the door, you know, the seal of stability, compassion, power, all of these seals coming off that doorway to union. And it's showing you the power within you. So the masculines are finding the power right now because they are receiving signs and synchronicities. And feminines, you're receiving signs and synchronicities. So if you're searching for answers right now, they're going to come to you through signs. And this will be how your higher self and your masculine's higher self are communicating. We've got self-sabotage. So remember, if you stay in fear or worry energy, it creates a self-sabotage. What you think about, you bring about. So make sure you're only seeing it in a positive way. Let go of doubt, let go of fear, and replace it with faith. And the masculine self-sabotage things for themselves, because they feel that they aren't worthy of their feminine. So they create things in their life as distractions that they need the courage to move away from to actually find themselves again. And they sabotage things because they don't feel like they deserve you. But they know who you are. You know, you're their queen, and it's not just any queen. This is the queen of emotion, the queen of cups. Powerful, sensitive, loving, kind, and the king, the queen of wands. So, you know, I'm seeing this in the way that you are, passionate, fiery. So they see you as sexual, you know, intense, creative, magical, yet they see you as sensitive at the same time. So you're coming up as two queens, two great queens here to show you what they are attracted to. The sides and the parts of you that they can't stay away from, that they find the courage to come and find, because you are everything that they are seeking. And, you know, we've got the money there again, you know, sorting out money situations, priorities, getting things in order right now for the future, you know, because you're the Empress. So you've come up as two great queens and the Empress to remind you, feminine, to keep your thoughts positive, that you are the nurturer. That it's your compassion, understanding that guides them on. And that's what helps them become their true king. You know, their true one. They are striving to be the emperor, which means they are sorting out finances, obligations, things they've got going on the 3D realm. But they're also standing strong in power and becoming who you need them to be. I absolutely love this. Thank you, angels. Look at the power in this. You know, you've got the king and the queen. Sorry, well, let me get them out. The king and the queen of cups here. So we've got the queen and the king of wands coming up. And we've got the queen and the king of cups coming up. Now, that's just amazing for the masculines, because that's showing you the power here in this reading. Because the masculines are attracted to you and you're attracted to them. You are mirrors of each other. So it shows that when you're feeling the passion, your masculine is feeling the passion. When your masculine is in emotion, you're feeling his emotion. You're feeling each other, you're mirroring each other. And this isn't about horoscopes, okay? Because you could say, well, you know, I'm an Aries and he's a Cancer and, you know, that's fire and water. And it is about fire and water to the extent where, you know, you balance each other's energies. But this is about the power coming in, the strength of the emotion, the intensity of the passion, that, you know, you're becoming one, you know, you're mirroring each other. So it's showing you how intense the connection is. And wow, look at this, feminine, self-love. And we know that this is the key right now. This is the key for February. And it's the key for 2020 to work on you, to rise up, to work on self-love. And that's why I'm so excited to be bringing you this Find Your Way to Union series, because it's going to help you to work with self-love, to find yourself, to realize how powerful you are. Oh, wow, look at that. To have faith in the journey. You know, you couldn't write this. And if you're seeing 22 or 222, a huge sign that things are moving forward right now. You know, self-love is the key to everything. And it's showing you a forward motion. So you're going to find your way, Divine Feminine, because you are the High Priestess. So the more you tune into you, the more you tune into who you are, the better things will be, because that's where your power is. You know, you are a being of love and light. You're tapped into source energy. So tune into that power. It makes you strong. It gives you faith, and it helps you to let go of the past. to release and let go, to trust in the journey, to move away from anything that's holding you back. So anything that feels stuck, give it to heaven. Surrender, let go, and be in your power. So when you're coming up as the Queen of Swords here, you're in your power, setting boundaries, working on you. Yet your masculine sees you in your emotion energy and in your passion energy. But when you're doing you, you're strong. And that's what I'm feeling with this card. They're showing here the wheel. So fate and destiny moving things forward now. You know, there's no getting out of this journey. You can't unlove your twin flame. All you can do is give it to heaven and trust that fate and destiny are turning the wheel in motion and that things will fall into place. Because, you know, the light is coming through there. Whatever struggles are going on, whatever obstacles are in the way, the light is starting to break through and you've seen the truth, you've seen the way forward. So set those intentions, plan, visualize, talk to the universe, plant those seeds now for what you want to reap later, because your masculine is tuning into who they are. There's power coming in here, strength, and it's showing you that, you know, you get knocked down, but you get back up because the angels give you the faith that you need. And when you work on self-love and remain positive, 111, it helps you to stand tall. And that will bring in everything you're asking for. Happiness, love, union, joy. All the things that you want are there for the taking. And the angels are showing you this today. And I think this is why I've been guided to this as well, because it's the dragon here and it's the fairy. So this is beautiful because, you know, your masculine is like the dragon that's transforming, that can blow hot and cold air, you know, that can be very, very angry and intense, yet so powerfully calm. And you are the one who stands there in your power with your hands on your hips saying, I'm here, you know, this is who I am, take it or leave it. This is how you become transformed on this journey. And it's showing that you are eternally bonded. Now, some cards jumped on the floor and you could say, well, that's a lot of cards, Liz. But, you know, everything happens for a reason, so I'm going to do them. So the masculines are becoming the emperor. That's who you need them to be because you are the empress. It's showing here, putting your money away, sorting things out. And the masculines are focused right now. They're getting their act together. Yes, they feel they're being judged on the 3D, but they're working through it because the tower and chaos is happening to help them to face their fears. And they need to bring balance in, to prepare for a journey, to move forward to you. Celebrations coming in. So they are becoming the magician. And feminine, you're becoming the magician now. You know, standing strong. This is where you were in January and now coming into February, working on coming forward. It's showing a forward motion, taking control, things falling into place, ascension, doorways opening. Have patience at this time. Trust that there's something better coming. That your masculine has been healed, that you're reflecting, that your masculine is watching you, even if it seems like they've disappeared, because union is coming. The new relationship, the rebirth of this relationship is coming, and you have to stand strong. The masculines are standing strong right now, learning to speak the truth, facing their truth, finding who they are, becoming the emperor for you. So you have to trust in the journey because it's all going to lead to your happiness and it's all going to lead to this beautiful new beginning. What the angels are saying to you, you know, a new start, a fresh start here, happiness and love. So just trust it's all falling into place. This is a real month of self-love. And when you work on that and most of all keep the faith and pay attention to the signs around you, you will realize your masculine is gaining the courage to leave things behind, to move forward to you. So keep the faith today. Keep the faith, let go, smile. Tomorrow's a brand new day and it's a brand new week and we're starting a brand new series. So breathe freely, relax, let go and trust that everything is falling into place. Have a beautiful day and I'll see you soon.